I'm not that talented, I can't dance and sit. Howdy y'all, it's Anna with Always Right, and in today's like Tuesday vlog, it is Tuesday as of recording this vlog, and that is because, oh my god, I had the Thanksgiving meal kit giveaway on Saturday. Here we are. We are bagging up the food to go. We have our pie station, our roll station, turkey gravy, all of our beautiful canned goods. And then over there, we have the turkeys. Oh god, it was a lot. It was amazing. It was very satisfying. We had amazing volunteer turnout as well as an amazing community turnout. So we actually ended up with 114 Thanksgiving meal kits that we gave away. And then we gave away like 3 turkeys with like some turkey gravy, like mix-in seasoning stuff. And like some yams, because that's like the only things we had in excess of was yams, turkey gravy seasoning mix stuff, and 3 extra turkeys. So we gave those out. Originally with this program, we were planning on donating 40 of those meal kits to like 3 different nonprofits in town, like our housing authority, our resource center, and then like victim services, you know, for abuse victims around the county. And yeah, one problem with working in nonprofit and trying to work with other nonprofits is that a lot of times the people you're trying to work with in the other nonprofits are what is called burned out, and they don't give a single hoo-ha, hootie-dang-darn. Put it the nice way. We set up the time, we set up the date, we tried to contact one of them we couldn't even get a hold of. The other one, they like rent our building, so we were able to track them down. But the lady didn't want to spend her Friday actually helping her people that are in her programs. So instead, we ended up just basically giving victim services their food that they were able to get families for. And so that was like 11 of the 40 that we had like scheduled to hand out. I will say, I was very panicked when I found out we had like 103 Thanksgiving meals to still give out, and we had to get rid of them on Saturday. I don't know why. I live in a pretty modest sized town. It's not like a big city, but it's not like a little hee-haw town, totally. We're kind of a hee-haw town. And I was really nervous. I was like, oh my god, we're not gonna get enough people, you know, we're gonna have like these 20 extra turkeys, what are we gonna do? And yeah, we ended up getting a youth kind of volunteer group down there. And they were able to do most of the heavy lifting and like do all the like running around and stuff. It was amazing on Saturday. It went really well. Friday was like the packing stuff in the bags, kind of time schedule stuff. And it went smoothly. I laid it out in a way, as you probably saw in the video clip, that made it pretty easy to just kind of go around with your bag and fill it up without like being too stressed, in my opinion, because I did it, and I'm just saying, I didn't have much stress doing it. It went really well. I'm very happy with the results. We ended up giving away the 103 complete meal kits and the 3 additional random turkeys within 75 minutes of beginning the distribution. And oh my god, like we had people even coming up after we had closed and we were like packing up and stuff. They're like, hey, do you have any turkeys? Do you have food left? And I'm just like, no, like we had to turn away 10 families. So good thing, bad thing at the same time. Good thing is we got rid of all the turkeys. We were able to help 117 families in theory. And, but the bad thing is that there was still need in the community, but there's always gonna be need. That's not what this is about. I just wanted to tell y'all that it went really well. I didn't get any writing done. I got done with the event and I was exhausted. I came home, I took like a 3-hour hard nap on my couch, and it was like one of those ones where like you wake up and you're like, where am I? What year is it? What? And it didn't help that I'd been playing like on my PlayStation, and it had gone into rest mode. It had been that long that it like shut itself down. It goes, you're not doing anything. I'm gonna go to sleep too. So I had like the aquarium going on my screen. So it went back to the Roku, which was on idle, which is the aquarium. And I was just like, where am I? Then on Sunday, I was just absolutely exhausted and did not want to do anything. So I did not. On to the second part of this video, because there were two major bits in the title, as you probably saw. So it is the 24th of November, aka we have like 5 full days of writing left-ish, you know? And I am not going to win Nano this year. It is a shame, a rightful shame. I kind of had a feeling coming into my November. I went, I don't think I can do NaNoWriMo. And surprise, I was right. Here's my calendar. This is where I kind of keep track of my daily word count. This is what kind of encourages me to write besides like my vlogs and y'all and all that stuff. And I did really well the first day because I knew that the second, the third, and the fourth were going to be absolute shit shows at work because we had auction where we were going to buy houses and stuff. And that's exactly what we did. And it was an absolute shit show for those like 3 days. The first week, the first work week was absolutely crazy. You know, I was working to like 8-9 PM a lot of days. It's not great. So my first week was absolute garbage, except for the first day. And then the second week got a little bit better at the beginning. As you saw, it was like 2.6 thousand words. It was amazing. And then it was like work. All of my work days in November have been absolutely grueling, and I actually missed 2 days that I was supposed to have off because of like this Thanksgiving meal giveaway. I failed Nano this year. I'm calling it. I have like 16,000 words done. That leaves me 34,000 words to do. And for my emotional and physical health, I am not going to try that shit. I know, call me silly. That is 5 full days to get 34,000 words. That's almost 7,000 words a day. I don't think I could do it. If I could, you should fear me. I'm a god, but I can't. July, I was at peak. I had everything outlined. It was going smoothly. I wrote pretty consistently for July. Like, first day of July was 2.8, 2.4, 3.5, 1.6, 3.1. And that was after a full, like, previous 3 weeks of just hammering words out. Specifically, words on, like, my Sundays. As you can tell, there's a cycle for me. My Tuesdays and Wednesdays are absolute garbage writing days for me. Because that's, like, the middle of the work week, you know, I'm doing this, doing that, trying to get my work done. And then at this time period, this was when I could finish my work by Wednesday, or I would be done with it by like Thursday and I'd have all of Friday to write. This month has just been an absolute whirlwind. It's been amazing. I've learned so much this month. It's been a great kind of self-reflection kind of month or whatever. So I am gonna put a pause on my Nano project. Officially. I can't do 7,000 words a day, 5 days in a row. Good God, I'm not a monster. I'm not like a writing monster, I'm sorry. God, I remember the one time I did 10K in a day, I think it was 9.8 thousand words or something. And like the next day, my brain was just goop. And I was just like, I know what a spoon is. I think I know how to use it. That's kind of like how I was the next day. So I don't want to do that for 5 days in a row, especially when one of those days is Thanksgiving. Thank y'all so much for watching. Thank y'all so much for supporting me through NaNoWriMo. I'm still cheering for y'all. I'm not saying, ugh, Nano is garbage. I can't win it. No one can win it. It's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying, with my current circumstances, with my work I had going on, I did not win Nano. I am going to take a break for a week, and then I'm gonna go back to my first book and edit it, and I'm gonna try to get the second draft done for my book. I'm going to get the second draft done for my June, July book and get her done and out there. So thank y'all so much for watching. I hope y'all are having an amazing NaNo. You have one more week. I believe in you. You got this. Let's do it, guys. But I'm Anna with Always Write. As always, let's get writing. Bye. Let's see you Friday. Yeah, looking forward to it.